टॉपिक सोशल मीडिया एडिक्शन, अ मिथ और अ रियलिटी। ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ एडिक्शंस फेल व्हेन इट कम्स टू दिस एडिक्शन। यंग और ओल्ड, सिक हैंडीकैप्ड और परफेक्टली हेल्दी, मेल और फीमेल, चाइल्ड और टॉडलर और टीनेजर, मास्टर और सर्वेंट, दिस न्यू एडिक्शन हैज बिकम अ न्यू नॉर्म एंड एन इंडिस्पेंसिबल पार्ट ऑफ आवर लाइव्स। We all agree that there are amazing benefits of social media, be it travel within the country or across the globe, or registration for puja, or ticket booking by train, or air travel, bill payments, telemedicine, doctor's consultation, telephone and electricity bills, Aadhaar or PAN card registration or editing, counseling online classes, etc. Everything seems perfect online. Checking and scrolling through social media has become an increasingly popular activity over the last decade. Although the majority of people's use of social media is non-problematic, there is a small percentage of users that become addicted to social networking sites and engage in excessive or compulsive use. In fact, psychologists estimate that as many as 5 to 10% of people meet the criteria for social media addiction today. Social media addiction is a behavioral addiction that is characterized as being overly concerned about social media, driven by an uncontrollable urge to log on to or use social media, and devoting so much time and effort to social media that it impairs other important life areas. And now my friend Ujjwal Singh Bisht will clarify our doubts on social media. Welcome, Ujjwal. Ujjwal, what is meant by social media?
The term social media refers to a computer-based technology that facilitates the sharing of ideas, thoughts, and information through virtual communication of content such as personal information, documents, videos, networks, and communities.
Okay, great information. Can you give some examples of social media?
Well, it is a collective term for websites and applications that focus on communication, community-based input, interaction, content sharing, and collaboration. Mobile applications make these platforms easily accessible. Some popular examples of general social media platforms include Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn.
Okay, thanks. That's fine. Let's move to the next question. What are the different types of social media, Jewel?
The different types of social media networks are as follows. Social networks like Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn, media sharing networks like Instagram, Snapchat, and YouTube, discussion forums like Reddit, Quora, and Dig, bookmarking and content curation networks like Pinterest and Flipboard, consumer review networks like Yelp, Zomato, and TripAdvisor.
But why is social media so important?
Social media is important because it allows us to reach, nurture, and engage with our target audience, no matter the location. When a business can use social media to connect with its audience, it can use social media to generate brand awareness, leads, sales, and revenue.
Ujjwal, tell me, what is social about social media?
All medias are social in the sense that they establish and maintain relations between and among humans as individuals and collectives, increasingly across space and time.
Now I know what it means. This is the last one, Ujjwal. Why do we keep posting on social media?
Yes, this is something important. Users generally want to post to feel some kind of social acceptance from a group or a particular individual. They look for the love and sense of belonging from social media platforms. People want to quell the rewards-oriented parts of their brains, which helps explain why people post me-centric content regularly. They are low on self-esteem.
One more last question. How social media affects teenagers?
Social media use can negatively affect teens, distracting them, disrupting their sleep, and exposing them to bullying, rumor spreading, unrealistic views of other people's life, and peer pressure. The risk might be related to how much social media teens use.
Oh my God! Such negative impact on brain of the young ones. We must put a full stop to all this. I am very thankful to Ujjwal who clarified so many doubts on social media. Now we have Parikshit Bisht with us to answer our questions. Welcome, Parikshit. Parikshit, What does social media do to our brain?
Social media has the ability to both capture and scatter your attention. With a simple refresh, constant new information is at your fingertips. Not only does this lead to poorer cognitive performance, but also strains parts of the brain associated with maintaining attention. Low attention span leading to ADHD is a consequence visible in children.
Why social media is so addicting?
Social media seems like mindless and relaxing fun-filled activity. It has a significant effect on your brain. Whenever you log on to your favorite apps, dopamine signals in your brain increases. These neurotransmitters are associated with pleasure. They create a sense of euphoria.
Thank you, Parikshit, for clarifying our doubts on social media. Now my friend Vikas will discuss with us some important impact of social media. Welcome, Vikas. What is the bad effects of social media?
The more time spent on social media can lead to cyberbullying, social anxiety, depression, and exposure to content that is not age appropriate. It may lead to mood modification and disorders, behavioral, cognitive, and emotional preoccupation, cell tolerance, ever increasing use over time, withdrawal symptoms, experiencing unpleasant physical and emotional symptoms. When social media use is restricted or stopped, conflict and relapse. Addicted individuals quickly revert back to their excessive social media usage after an abstinence period. The phenomena of social media addiction can be largely attributed to the dopamine including social environments that social networking sites provide. Social media platforms such as Facebook, Snapchat, and Instagram produce the same neural circuitry that is caused by gambling and recreational drugs to keep consumers using their products as much as possible. Studies have shown that the constant system stream of retweets, likes, and shares from these sites cause the brain's reward area to trigger the same kind of chemical reaction seen with drugs like cocaine. In fact, neuroscientists have compared social media interaction to a serine dopamine being injected straight into the system.
Thank you, Vikas, for clarifying our doubts on social media. Now my friend Ashutosh Tiwari will share some bad effects of social media to our brain. Welcome, Ashutosh. I now invite my friend Ashutosh Tiwari who will share the bad impact of social media on human brains. Welcome, Ashutosh.
Hello, everyone. Due to the effect that it has on the brain, this media is addictive both physically and psychologically. According to a new study by Harvard University, these networking sites light up the same part of the brain that also ignites when taking an addictive substance. The reward area in the brain and its chemical messenger pathways affect decisions and sensations. When someone experiences something rewarding or uses an addictive substance, neurons in the principal dopamine producing areas in the brain are activated and dopamine levels rises. Therefore, the brain receives a reward and associates the drug or activity with positive reinforcement. This is observable in its usage when an individual gets a notification, such as a like or mention. The brain receives a rush of dopamine and sends it along reward pathways, causing the individual to feel pleasure. The brain rewires itself through this positive reinforcement, making people desire likes, retweets, and emotion reactions. Its use becomes problematic when someone views social networking sites as an important coping mechanism to relieve stress, loneliness, or depression. Its use provides these individuals with continuous rewards that they are not receiving in real life, so they engage in the activity more and more. This continuous use eventually leads to multiple interpersonal problems, such as ignoring real life relationships, work or school responsibilities, and physical health, which may then increase an individual's undesirable moods. This then causes people to engage in the social networking behavior even more as a way of relieving dysphoric mood states. Thank you.
Thank you, Ashutosh Tiwari, for discussing the bad impact of social media to our brain. I now invite my learned friends Nilay Khetwal and Kartikeya Nair, who will discuss the statistics and the numeric figures when we talk of social media addiction.
Too much is too much, but right now, limit seems too hard. Let's have a look on some statistics. Here's a graph of how many people access the internet, how many people access the internet using their mobile devices, how many people use social media, and how many people use social media using their mobile devices. As you see, out of the 4.6 billion users worldwide, 4.2 billion internet users use social media, which is about 95% of the internet users worldwide. And out of those 4.2 billion users, 4.15 billion users use their mobiles to access social media. And India isn't behind, because India is the second largest country with the highest social media users. Now what's bad with it, you might think? And that's because social media has disguised itself as a place which connects people together, helps them make new friends and all sorts of good stuff, while the dark side stays in. Now this conveniently brings us to our next point, social media addiction. Now have a look on some statistics. The blue indicates the usage in 2012 and the orange indicates the usage in 2018. And without even any reading, we can see that the changes are drastic and the results are devastating. So let's have a look. The number of people checking social media daily in 2012 was 37%, while now almost 70% of the people check social media daily. But you might notice something. The amount of people not using social media has somewhat remained constant. And that's because they were not in the rabbit hole, and so they don't see social media as appealing as the other users see it. And one of the most major parts of the rabbit hole are the echo chambers. Echo chambers are like an effect which occur online when a group of people develop tunnel vision. A participant of a group might see his opinion constantly echoing back to him, which reinforces his beliefs due to their declining exposure to the other's opinion. How many people are suffering from this? Well, according to the stats, a whooping 333 million people are estimated to suffer from this. And this brings us to our next topic of concern, teenagers using their mobiles during late night. And yes, this means they are one of those 33 million people, but also that blue light can harm sleep schedules and make them further more addicted. Look at this graph. While experts advise against using their phones during night or around bedtime, kids do it. Like as this shows, around 29% of the teens sleep with their phones near their bed, 32% check their phones within 5 minutes of waking up and further on. This shows how much we are dependent and are addicted to social media. If you want to know if females are more addicted to social media than any other gender, then stay tuned to find out. As my friend Kartike explained further. My name is Nilay. Thank you.
I now invite Kartike Nair, who will discuss the statistics when we talk of social media addiction. Welcome, Kartike.
Hello, everyone. Are females more addicted than any other gender? Men versus women, site-specific social media usage. Among internet users, the percentage of men versus women who use the following sites. Women use Facebook more than men by 10%. Women are at 72% while men are at 62%. Women also use more social media websites more than men, except Twitter and Reddit. Most people sleep next to their phones. Which situation best describes the last time you usually consult your smartphone? 53% of people say that they use their phones before going to bed. And 13% of people say that they use their phones when they come back from school or work. Teenagers check their phones more than 10 times per night. Blue light can harm sleep. Teens increasingly use screens in bed. 68% of young people think that using screens in bed can harm schoolwork. 45% of teenagers check their phones at night. 10% do so more than 10 times a night. A lot of people check their phones while driving. 47% of people receive phone calls while driving. 94% believe that using phones while driving can be unsafe and dangerous. 68% support the use of enforcement cameras so that the drivers don't use phones while driving. Thank you. Also, the statistics and the data has been collected from websites and Google. Thank you.
Thank you, Nilekhet Pal and Karthikeyan for discussing the statistics when we talk of the social media addiction. I now invite our last participant for our assembly, Priya Joshi, who will conclude the assembly.
Hello everyone. Social media is important for various things, but it has more disadvantages than advantages. Social media causes negative effects on the mental health of teens. Teens who use social media the most become addicted to some of the sites or applications. Every time they log on to the sites, dopamine is elevated in the brain. It is every person's duty to monitor themselves and save themselves from this addiction. Conclusion: the excessive usage of social media causes negative impact on family as well as deterioration of family equations. Here are some preventive measures that people should take to stop themselves from being an addict. First, parental control. Parents should keep their children aware about social media and its addiction. Second, school curriculum. School should give life skill classes on social media addiction. Third, stress busters. Therapies like music therapy, aromatherapy, laughter therapy should be performed. Meditation and yoga should be made compulsory in schools. Consult to your doctor or psychologist if necessary, or a routine checkup of mental health, especially teenagers. A balanced equation will save us from the new disease that afflicts everyone. Hope we become wiser, nicer, and make others too. Thank you.
Now, the boarders of our class will present a beautiful song on social media addiction. The lyrics of the song have been changed by our class teacher, Mrs. Shivani Dubey Nath. Here goes the song. देख तेरे इंसान की हालत क्या हो गई भगवान कितना बदल गया इंसान
देख तेरे संसार की हालत क्या हो गई भगवान कितना बदल गया इंसान कितना बदल गया इंसान
देख तेरे संसार की हालत क्या हो गई भगवान कितना बदल गया इंसान कितना बदल गया इंसान
सूरज ना बदला चांद ना बदला रे आसमान कितना बदल गया इंसान कितना बदल गया इंसान
सूरज ना बदला चांद ना बदला रे आसमान कितना बदल गया इंसान कितना बदल गया इंसान
आया समय बड़ा बेढंगा आदमी बना लफंगा कहीं पे फेसबुक कहीं पे इंस्टा नाच रहा नर बन कर पगला कहीं पे 4G कहीं पे 5G कनेक्शन की है मार
कितना बदल गया इंसान कितना बदल गया इंसान देख तेरे संसार की हालत क्या हो गई भगवान कितना बदल गया इंसान कितना बदल गया इंसान
राम के भक्त रहीम के बंदे रचते हैं व्हाट्सएप के फंडे कितने ये मक्कार ये अंधे देख लिए इंटरनेट के धंधे इन्हीं की काली करतूतों से मीडिया है बदनाम
कितना बदल गया इंसान कितना बदल गया इंसान देख तेरे संसार की हालत क्या हो गई भगवान कितना बदल गया इंसान कितना बदल गया इंसान
काहे मोबाइल टीवी से चिपकते बने हुए क्यों टास्क बिगड़ते जो हम मोबाइल को न झगड़ते क्यों बच्चे माँ बाप से बिछड़ते फूट फूट कर क्यों रोते प्यारे पेरेंट्स महान
कितना बदल गया इंसान कितना बदल गया इंसान देख तेरे संसार की हालत क्या हो गई भगवान, कितना बदल गया इंसान, कितना बदल गया इंसान। सूरज न बदला, चांद न बदला, ना बदला रे आसमान, कितना बदल गया इंसान, कितना बदल गया इंसान।
Presenting news. The management, along with the teachers and students, bid an emotional farewell to Mr. Ravi Shankar, sir, and Ms. Nalini Rawat on their retirement. The corridors and classrooms shall never be the same again, as both of them will be leaving us. We are surely going to miss you, sir and ma'am. We wish you good luck and God's blessing wherever you may go. Here's a clip.
Good morning, Brother Principal. Brother Superior, staff and students. Today we all have gathered here to bid farewell to our colleagues and your teachers, Ms. M. Rawat and Mr. R. Shankar.
Dear God, thank you for the seasons of life, for the joy of childhood, the excitement of youth, and the stability of maturity. Thank you for the blessings that come with age, for all the happy memories to enjoy, for the wisdom that comes through experience, and for the freedom that is given with retirement. Lord, we give thanks for the tremendous blessing that has come from the work of many years, and thank you that you still walk with us in all seasons. We pray that this would be a new beginning for our dear friends Mr. Ravi Shankar and Ms. Nalini Rawat. May your vision be their guide. May a new rhythm emerge, one that forms a beautiful balance between rest and engagement with life. And now, Lord, we ask for your blessing. May there be good health, joy in abundance, and peace in heart and mind from this day forward and each day that follows.
I have the immense pleasure of working with Ms. Nalini Rawat for the past 32 years. As both of us have seen each other grow during this time, I would like to share some beautiful memories of Ms. Rawat, as she was not just a colleague, but a dear friend. I remember how she was a patient listener and teacher with the boys of class 4. It was the class she taught for most of her stint at 7. Whether it was a boarder or a day scholar, all her students loved and respected her.
अभी अलविदा न कहो दोस्तों, न जाने कहाँ फिर बुला कर दो। रिस्पेक्टेड ब्रदर, स्टाफ, कर्मचारी एवं बच्चों, शुभ प्रभात। आज हम सभी मिस रावत एवं मिस्टर शंकर के विदाई समारोह के आयोजन में एकत्रित हुए। मिस रावत 3 दशक से भी अधिक कार्यकाल के दौरान विद्यालय में आपने शिक्षण कार्य के साथ साथ जो भी विद्यालय की उन्नति है ब्रदर द्वारा तौर तरीके सीखे सर्वदा हम लोगों के साथ साझा किए, ताकि एक सुव्यवस्थित एवं परंपरा बन रहे।
Respected teachers and my dear friends, we are gathered here to bid farewell to a highly valuable teacher, Ms. Nalini Rawat, who has given 30 years of service to this school and is retiring today. Teaching is the profession that created all other professions. We are grateful that you chose to be a teacher and we learned valuable lessons under your guidance.
We are gathered here to bid farewell to Miss Nalini Rawat. Miss Rawat is one of the most responsible and committed teachers of our college.
Good morning, respected brothers, teachers, and my dear friends. Today, we all are present here for the farewell of our junior school coordinator and also the class teacher of 5th A, Ms. Nalini Rao. She has been serving our school for past many years. We are all here to wave goodbye to our venerable teacher. I feel the honor to say that we must respect all the valuable skills and knowledge imparted by our dear miss. Thank you.
To bid farewell to our dear, respected Mr. Ravi Shankar, who has been in this institution for 31 years. Sir, as you begin your new journey, I would like to take this opportunity to express our deep appreciation for your hard work. It has been lovely to work with you. As the time we have spent with you, you have really worked hard for this institution. It is very sad to see you go, but wishing you happiness as you begin a new chapter in your life.
We have gathered here to bid farewell to Ms. Nalini Rao. This is an excellent opportunity for us to express our gratitude towards the hard work and compassion with which Ms. has taught here for a long period of time. While I never had the honor of being personally taught by her, her appraisal resonates throughout the campus. She is one of the most sincere and dedicated teachers who has served as a source of inspiration for many students. She is friendly, kind, and motivated.
Goodbyes are so hard, but also so special, as we have the opportunity to say how special is the person to them. So on this occasion of farewell of my dear teacher, Mr. Ravi Shankar, I will say a few words on it. Today I have realized how time and valued moments fly. I feel the honor to say that we have learned lots of practical life skills from sir. We are also thankful to sir for teaching us with great sincerity, hard work and patience.
Good morning everyone. For the life you live, for the joy you give to everyone around you, may happy hours like lovely flowers blossom surround you. Dear sir, my eyes are in tears seeing you leave, for the soul and heart of the classrooms in SEM will leave alongside you. Your work, values and cheerful nature will be with me. You are a role model in school, and your dedicated years to this institution have influenced it for the better and will always be cherished.
Today, as we all are aware, we are gathered here to extend our deep sense of thankfulness and to bid goodbye to our two beloved teachers, Ms. Nalini Rawat and Mr. Ravi Shankar, who are retiring from the active service.
Did my journey in St. Joseph's is ending after more than 31 glorious and eventful years. I would like to thank the brothers, all the staff and my dear students. A big thank you to all of you. When I joined SEM, I often heard the expression SEM family, and later I understood what it stands for, as it never was a workplace but a home, a vocation not a profession. And it was because of the implicit trust the brothers placed in us, their encouragement and support in what SEM is, what SEM is all about. I thank all the brothers for their trust and guidance.
Brothers, teachers and Samites, my dear fellow students, 31 years in SEM has been a great time of learning and great adventure. I think
I must serve the purpose for which I was sent here in 1991. My God will judge me for what I've done. Wherever I am going to be, I will always carry and send my heart. I would like to tell you all what I experienced here in St. Joseph's College, Nainital. Has got a great blessing. And I call it the Divine Great Spirit. I pray to the Spirit of Sen to bless each one of you and guide you in your journey ahead. Thank you.
Dear Ms. Nalini and Sir Ravi, on behalf of the Christian Brothers, I wish to place on record our deepest gratitude for many, many years of service we have put into this institution. Let's give them a very strong round of applause. That are ahead of you from today is it's an evidence of the effect you have had on this institution. Many things have been spoken about both Miss and Sir. I would like to sort of give it a small addition by placing three things that I am personally impressed and influenced by what you have the first one I'd like to mention is your love, care and compassion for the students. Both Miss and Sir, I've seen, are very, very concerned about students. Their compassion, their love comes through not just in their teaching, but the way they conduct themselves with students outside the classroom.
Dear Miss Rawat and Mr. Ravishankar, the teachers and the students. I like the hymn, "What a Friend We Have in Jesus." For us now, Jesus is for our Mr. Ravishankar and Rawat. They have been very good friends, and I found this hymn very, very appropriate for this occasion. And second, I want to just, before I forget, I want to note some points. Last night I was thinking, should I speak from my heart? If I speak from my heart, the speech goes on for hours. There's so many things to say. So I have both. I may miss some points. Now you just mentioned your journey has ended itself. No, your journey has begun in a different way. Meetings and partings are an integral part of life. I have seen that myself when I left from Mangalore, which I had associated for over 20 years, being a principal. I still have that connection. Traveling on the journey of life, we meet thousands of co-travelers at new junctions or stops, many alight and many more embark on. However, some of the co-travelers win everyone's heart with their noble living and compassionate nature. And when such jovial and helpful people part from us, we feel pangs of separatism from them. This is what I feel today. We are all here to bid farewell to Mr. Ravishankar and Ms. Rawat, who are exceptional teachers and mentors who will be retiring from active service in a few weeks' time. Today, we all realize how time flies. Both of them were supposed to retire last year, and I requested, because due to the difficult COVID times and online classes, I requested to continue and help us. And they very much apply. They are very happy. Give them a big hand for being with us during the difficult times.
Divya Himgiri Himalayan Education Excellence Award 2021. St. Joseph's College, Nainital has been selected by the High Level Award Screening Committee under the chairmanship of Sri Subhash Kumar, IAS Retired, for the 4th Himalayan Education Excellence Award under the category Best Senior Secondary Day Boarding School for the year 2021. Brother Hector Pinto received the award on 30th November at Vigyan Dham, Dehradun. We are also proud to announce that St. Joseph's College has received Most Inspirational School in India by Education Today. St. Joseph's College is now the third best residential day school in India and the best in our state. Congratulations to our principal, Brother Hector Pinto, and Brother Superior Ryan Fernandez, teachers and staff who made this possible with their hard work, grit, persistence and commitment. The India School Merit Awards 2021 would be held on January 11th in Bangalore. Due to the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic and the new Omicron strain in some states, the school decided for online mode of final examinations, which started on 6th of December and shall get over on the 15th of December 2021. 29th November was the last day of offline school for day scholars, while 30th of November was the last for our dear boarders. Hence, parents came to pick their wards on the 30th. Report on news via DD4. News Literacy Program. The News Literacy Program Session 3 was attended by our school justice team. The following social justice animators and students selected for the program participated. The students felt that the session was very encouraging, motivating and a great learning experience. They also had assignments to make memes for fake news awareness and other various assignments. It was a great and informative experience indeed. We congratulate Lieutenant General Shankar Ghosh, class of 1966, who wrote an article with the headline, "The Baby Batch Stressed with Destiny," published in the Tribune on 5th December 2021. The article gives an insight about the young boys, some barely in teens, but full of enthusiasm, who launched into combat in 1971. November 14, 2021, 50 years down the line, the same teenagers were all now veterans in their 70s. SEM Basketball League 2021 was organized by Physical Education Department from 7th December till the finals on 8th of December. The chief guest for the tournament was our principal, respected Brother Hector Pinto. The four teams which participated in the tournament were number 1, Lake Dunkers coached by Mr. Dharmendra Sharma, number 2, Tully Shooters coached by Mr. Rakesh Bhatt, number 3, Mali Rappers coached by Mr. Birendra Manral, and lastly, Cliff Jumpers coached by Mr. Arthur Knight. The winner team was Tully Shooters, while the runners-up team was Lake Dunkers. The individual prizes were given to Pratham Bisht as the rising player, Pravar Bahuguna as the best shooter, and Smriti Pandey as a promising player. Here's a clip.
PL in the building. Oh, I'm in the zone, man. Yeah. Now tell me who can stop me, I'm in the zone. Competition's none in a league of my own. All about the W, I'ma bring it home. When it's over with, I'ma be the king of the throne. Now who can stop me, I'm in the zone. Competition's none in a league of my own. All about the W, I'ma bring it home. When it's over with, I'ma be the king of the throne. I'm in the zone, look, I'm in the zone. The competition way, tell them let's get it on. My hustle game crazy and I'ma finish strong. You threw up so many bricks, you probably could build a home. I done came a long way, this is what the grind make. Everybody want the shine, don't know what the shine take. You mad that I'm playing? Call it sideline. Hey, it ain't over till it's over, buzzer be the mind state. If I ain't in the zone, then what you call this? They ask me how I do it, I tell them all risk. Why y'all miss? What? I could probably do a backflip, fade away, and still watch the ball switch. Ooh. Camera flash when I step up to the podium. Hey. Haters looking salty, easy on the sodium. Hey. You should plan to lose if you thinking about folding them. Even with a joystick, it's still no control. No can stop me. I'm in the zone. Competition's none in a league of my own. All about the W, I'ma bring it home. When it's over with, I'ma be the king of the throne. Now who can stop me? I'm in the zone. Competition's none in a league of my own.
a B. All about the W like after the letter V. They say they win, but I ain't heard of them cats. And since we talking about a winner, I am certainly that. AA, came to play, but now I'm turning them back. Them boys low, I'm wearing retired jerseys, be at. Just look up, my kicks lace, my team strong. They sleeping on me, dream on. They know I ain't stopping until the ring's on. Hey, look, I'm headed for greatness, and it's not telling me so. Stop me, I'm in the zone. Competition's none in a league of my own. All about the W, I'ma bring it home. When it's over with, I'ma be the king of the throne. Now who can stop me? I'm in the zone. Competition's none in a league of my own. All about the W, I'ma bring it home. When it's over with, I'ma be the king of the throne. I'm in the zone.
The school shows appreciation and gratitude to the interns who were with us for a period of 45 days for their internship program. Thank you so much, Mr. Ashish Jasrogia, Ms. Ashna Rajput, Mr. Vivek Thakur, Mr. Ritik Porte, Mr. Dinesh Brijwal, Mr. Lalit Bish, and Ms. Madhu Pandey for all your hard work. It was great having you all here. The nation mourns the untimely and tragic death of our CDS General Bipin Rao, along with 13 members on board in the chopper crash in Kurnool district. Our deepest condolences and prayers with the family to be able to cope with this irreparable loss.
ऐ मेरी जमी अफसोस नहीं जो तेरे लिए सौ दर्द सहे महफूज रहे तेरी आन सदा चाहे जान मेरी ये रहे ना रहे
आ मेरी जमी महबूब मेरी मेरी नस नस में तेरा इश्क बहे फीका ना पड़े कभी रंग तेरा जिस्मों से निकल के खून कहे
from the SEM News section. Have a good day. I'm Karthikeyan Arth of Class 8A. We now close the assembly with the college anthem.
You heard of many a school I draw and many a college too. But there is one that always is the best for me. It's first on Annie's lovely day, and our dads were there all four. For a century and more is known as the home of the true and bold. For a century and more is known as the home of the true and bold. Was called at first the good old Sam, and later SJC. Here a place cannot be found, at least for you and me. This boy's a heart to beat, my friend, in classroom wheel of fame. Their motto down the years has been, make sure to play the game. Their motto down the years has been, make sure to play the game. Here's to the boys of SJC, to our children, every man. And pass the word to those who come, give the motto of the clan. And down the years to fight life's fight, to fight its clean and lean. Among the boys who have kept the breed, our dear old SJC.
We hope you guys like our assembly. Your feedback and comments will be appreciated. May please give maximum likes, views or shares to us. In gratitude and appreciation.